Michelle back with another video. Today's video is a vampy kind of look tutorial. I just did this makeup look on my social media links and I just love it, so I thought I would just share it with you guys. I'm gonna put a disclaimer out in the beginning. I am not a professional makeup artist. This is just the way that I use makeup, I play around with makeup, and this is just the look that I came up with. So first I'm just going to start with these Bare Minerals Prime Time. It's face primer, but I use it for my eyelids and my whole entire face. Just rub it on my eyelids. And don't mind the crazy faces that I make in this video. So, yeah. And also don't mind my crazy hair, because that's not cute, but whatever. So now I'm taking this eyeshadow thing. I want to put out there that majority of my makeup is drugstore. So yeah, I don't know where I got this from, but I'm just using some orangey shades as transition in my crease. I'm going to grab these two lightest shades and I'm just going to mix them together, and I'm just going to use it as my transition shade to go into my crease. You're just gonna wanna blend it all into the crease, and you're gonna do the same thing for both eyes. Then just repeat it on both of the eyeballs. And I just blend it to the way I want it. You can also blend it, put it into different shape, however you want to, but this is just the way that I blend it. Now I feel like I'm starting to get sick because my voice is always going in and out, but don't mind that. Okay, so now I'm taking that thingamajigger that you guys saw in my makeup collection video. I'm just going to take it, and I'm going to take the Ulta palette that was inside of it. And then I'm going to take this pink color. It's in Thrill Seeker, as you can see me doing that. But it was in the color Thrill Seeker, and it's just like this really hot pink. It's a matte color. It looks glittery, but it isn't. It's just a matte pink kind of color. I'm just going to dust some of it off with my blending brush. I just noticed that the mirror was in the way, but as you can see, I just put it over on top of the orange. And I'm just going to go in with some more and do the same thing on the other eye. Gonna blend, and don't mind the reflection in the mirror, because like you can see my messy room, so don't mind that. And then I'm just doing the same thing with the colors. I went back in with the orange and the orange colors just to like soften it up a little bit, because I didn't want it to be like too pink. So that's what it looks like so far, and then I'm just rubbing off the color on my hand, because I don't want to switch brushes, so I'm just going to do that. And then I'm taking this darker, it's more of like a deep red, not like a deep red, but like a reddish purple. And then we're just going to focus that more on the corner, like you're making a V kind of, more on the color, and I'm just rubbing it in a circle, and then I just go into my crease with it. And I bring it into the crease. And you're just gonna repeat the same thing on the other eye. Then I'm just gonna just blend it normally. And just blend it to the way you feel like it's good. I'm just doing it. Okay, so now I'm taking this Ulta eyeshadow palette, and it's just a bunch of eyeshadows that are very, very shimmery and have a big glow to it. And then I'm just going to take this brush. It's like one of those flathead brush. I'm going to lick it so it can get more pigment on it. And I'm just going to lick it, and I'm going to mix a whole bunch of colors in like the whole entire brush. Sorry if you hear my dogs barking in the background, don't mind them. So I'm just going to mix all of those colors together, and then I'm going to put that onto my eyelid. And it's going to give it that type of glow. Just going to make it go like, pow, it's going to like, you know, give it that pop of color and shimmer. And you're just going to repeat the same step on the other eye. Gonna rub it onto the eyelids and make it the way you want to, and I'm just gonna keep adding and adding and adding just to make it more shimmery, and I'm just gonna add more as I like it. You can do the same thing, you don't have to use like the shimmers that I used, but it just gives it a nice glow. And then I just switched to my finger because like it gives it more pigment. So then that's what it looks like so far. And then I'm just taking the brush again. I didn't put any product on there. I'm just taking the brush and I'm blending it so it doesn't look as harsh. And then I'm going to take it's a Wet n Wild eyeshadow brush. And I'm going to take that brush, and I'm going to go in, I don't know what I'm doing here, but I'm going to go in with this darker brown type purple color, and I'm going to mix all three of those colors together, the ones that we use for our crease, and I'm going to put them under my waterline, eyeline, underneath where your bottom eyelashes are, so not in your waterline, but underneath it. And don't mind all these crazy faces that I'm making, because, you know, that's just what happened. Okay, so then that's what it's going to look like. It just adds a little bit of more color onto the look. And then I'm taking this gold shimmer shade. I'm going to take my finger and I'm just going to put it into the inner corner of my eye. That's what I think that. The inner corner of my eye, and it just adds more shimmer. And then just keep adding and adding till I like it. Okay, so now I'm going to take my eyelash curler and I'm just going to curl my eyelashes. So now I'm going to try out this mascara. It's the Smashbox Full Exposure Mascara. And, that's what the wand looked like. It is really, really big. I didn't really like the way it made my eyelashes look. It made them, like, really stuck together. It didn't really expand them out like I normally like it. So I ended up switching to, my, Clinique, mascara that I normally use because I just really didn't like it. As you can see, I didn't really like it, so now I'm just using the Clinique volumizing, I think that's what it's called, volumizing mascara, and I like love this mascara because I love the way the brush makes my eyelashes like spread, so yeah, and as you can see, I'm just placing it on my eyelashes top and bottom. And then that's what it looks like, and that is the finished eye look. Now we're gonna do the rest of my face. So we're gonna just start doing our face, and then we're gonna do the eyebrows, contour, highlight, foundation, all that stuff. And I'm taking my damp beauty blender. So now I'm taking my Maybelline Fit Me foundation in the color 225. And then I'm taking also the primer again. And we're just going to put that all over my face. Well, the primer first. You gotta keep us down. So now I'm just going to rub it all over my face. So then I just decided to just do my eyebrows. Now you guys already know how I do my eyebrows, so there's no need for me to explain. Tell me what to do. Okay, so then I'm done with my eyebrows. I got my beautiful eyebrows on. And then now we're just gonna start you putting on our foundation. Now, being I normally put it on like the back of my hand, but being at that time I had other makeup on top of my hand, so I just put it on top of the beauty blender and I just dabbed it all over my face. Okay, then you're just gonna dab, bring it down to your neck, because you don't want your face a different color than your rest of your body, your neck, whatever. So I just bring it down to my neck and I just dab it all over my face. I don't rub my foundation into my skin because I heard that it's bad for your skin, you can get wrinkles that way. So that's why I just dab it into my skin. So then I'm just dabbing and dabbing, making sure it looks good. And there you go. My scalp is really, really dry. I need like, if you have any suggestions on how to fix a dry scalp, let me know down below in the comments, because I could really use it. So I'm taking my e.l.f. e.l.f. HD powder. It's just baking powder. And I just use that to bang underneath my eyes. I totally forgot to put on concealer, but I normally don't use it anyway because I don't have a hard time with the dark circles. So I don't even put it on anyway. I just put baking to set my face. And yeah. I use that little sponge that comes inside of it, and I just put it underneath my eyeballs, and I just let it sit there as I finish doing the rest of my makeup. Now I have just white powder all underneath my eyeballs, so yeah. I find myself saying "so yeah" a lot, but I'm just gonna take my e.l.f. concealer brush and this CoverGirl powder palette, whatever, I don't know, I've had it for a very, very long time, as you can see, because it's already hit pan. I need to get another one, but yeah, we just use that, and I use that to contour my face, and I just go onto my cheekbones and I bring it up to my temples and my forehead. Even though I feel like my forehead isn't even that big, but it just brings some warmth into my face. And we just contour the cheeks and then the jawline. So as I'm contouring my jawline, I tend to bring it all the way down to my neck, and just sometimes I just bring it all the way down to my neck for the other leftovers that are on the brush. Then I'm just gonna use that same brush, and I'm gonna use the shimmer eyeshadow palette that we use before for our eyes, and I'm just gonna take from the light from that gold all the way down, and I love this as a highlighter. It makes such a good highlighter, and I just use it, and I use that same brush, and I just go and I highlight with it. Would you offer another money mine? I'm taking this other Ulta eyeshadow, and it's in the color Silk. I'm going to take that and use it as a highlighter, also to just go on top and make it even more snatched so my highlighter can be popping. And I'm just going to put that on the cheeks. Now I'm just wiping away the baking powder, and then I'm just gonna fix the highlight. I'm just gonna blend it a little bit more. And look at that highlighter, it's popping. Ooh, my contour, ooh. Yes. And then this is the finished look. I hope you enjoyed.